In this video, you will learn how to create digital fillable forms in Word. Some of you might have seen forms like that one, but this kind of form is very unprofessional and comes with two problems. The first problem is that when a user enters data, the underscores are not being deleted. Now, if the user leaves it like that, the document is a mess. And if the user has to delete all the underscores manually, the document provides a horrible user experience. The second problem is that the user can change the whole form and we probably don't want this. So let's now improve this document. For that, we will need the Developer tab. And since this tab is probably not visible for you, we have to make it visible. Therefore, we go to the File tab and open the Options. Then we switch to the Customize Ribbon section and in the right box we have to set a check mark for the Developer tab. Now we go back to the document and switch to this tab. In here we will find a section called Controls which contains text controls, image controls, checkbox controls and even more. These controls are fillable placeholder elements and we should use them in every spot where we want a person to input their data. So let's look at the first field in our form. There, we want a person to enter their name. A name is basically a plain text and therefore we will insert the plain text control here. Now, when a person wants to fill out the form, they could simply click into that control and enter their name and the default placeholder text will disappear. But let's go on with the other form entries now. In the next part of the form, we ask for the last name, which again is a plain text. But the third entry is a bit more advanced. There we want the user to be able to choose from three different options. And for that, the drop-down list control is perfect. After inserting the drop-down control, we have to add the choices to it. For that, we click in the control and then on Properties. In the bottom part of the new window, we first delete the default option by selecting it and clicking on Remove. And then we add all options we want the user to choose from. Now for the next question, we want a yes or no from the user. Therefore, we again could implement a drop-down list, but when having two choices, a simple checkbox is the better way to go. And in the last part of our form, we request an image from the user. There we obviously used the image control. So deciding which control to use should not be a problem for you anymore. Note that there are two controls which are very similar to other ones. The first one is the rich text control, which is almost the same as the plain text control. The difference is that the rich text control allows the user more formatting options. The second one is the combo box, which is almost the same as the drop-down list. The combo box is again a bit less restricted. With this control, the user can not only select an existing option, but he can also enter a custom text if he wants. After we clarified that, let's look at how we can change the placeholder text. First, we activate the design mode. Don't worry that the document looks a bit different now. This will go back to normal when we deactivate the design mode again. To now change the placeholder text, we simply have to click on the blue tags. When the text is selected, we can change the content by writing our custom text in here. We can of course also change the formatting for this text through the Home tab. And when we are finished, we deactivate the design mode. And for the end of this video, let's look at some advanced options for our controls. When we click into a control and open the properties, we can give each control a title. The title is a very good option if we don't have some explaining text around our control. So we could enter first name as our title here. And then if we delete the explaining text in front of the control, the user will still know what to enter since the control has a title. The next nice option is the coloring of the controls. This will allow us to create a better structure in longer forms, because we can, for example, make all text controls green, all drop-down controls yellow, and so on. This would also improve the user experience, as the user would recognize through the color what kind of information we want from him. Another option that is commonly used is the formatting of the user input. When we check the box which says Use a style, then we can select a style which will be applied to the text that the user enters. And with the last option, we can lock the editing and deletion of a control. Here it might make sense to lock the deletion, but definitely not the editing, since we want our user to fill out the form and not just look at it. There is one more thing that you should know. When clicking on Restrict Editing, we can set a checkmark for the editing restrictions and change them to Filling in Forms. When we then click on Start Enforcing and set a password, only the controls can be edited but not the rest of the document. Like that, no one can mess around with the document. So now you know how to create fillable forms in Word, how to customize the controls, and how to restrict the editing of the document. Go ahead and watch the other videos to learn more about Microsoft Word.